I think about this case every day. And I probably will until it's solved.
If you don't know what you're looking for, it's easy to miss. The overgrown lot off US 220 set back from a busy highway. Aside from the mailbox and driveway, there's nothing left of the short family home in Oak Level, Virginia. But ask Lieutenant Curtis Spence how it looked 17 years ago, and he'll paint a picture of the life Michael, Mary, and Jennifer Short shared.
The house was up for sale, and it looked like a show place. I mean, you could have put it in a magazine. There was nothing out of place inside the house.
Nothing out of place, but on August 15th, a horrific crime scene inside. Michael and Mary both found shot and killed that morning inside their home.
Single gunshot wound to the head. Sometimes he would actually lay down on a couch that was in the garage area, and that's when we found him. Mary was in the bed, in their bedroom.
Their 9-year-old daughter, Jennifer, was missing. And while the priority was the massive search to find the little girl, investigators were combing through every room in the Shorts' home for clues in what was now a double murder case.
I stayed in that house for over 2 weeks myself, just collecting evidence. I mean, we fingerprinted everything you could think of, including the walls.
Jennifer's mattress was moved just 2 inches out of place, her pillow on the floor, and someone had cut the phone line to the Short home.
Someone would have to have brought a tool with them to actually cut the phone line, and they would have had to have the knowledge of which lines to cut coming in. Well, all the phone lines were not cut, just the specific phone line that needed to be cut.
Search warrants show investigators pulled .22 caliber shell casings, a rifle and shotgun out of the home, along with $600 and a blank check. But Lieutenant Spence says they collected far more.
We've collected over 1,000 pieces of evidence, and normally the average case, you'd collect maybe 50 or 60. But you always had that piece of evidence that would give you the information that you needed. This particular case, we just didn't have it.
He says they can't say specifically what they found inside. It's all stored here in the Henry County Sheriff's Office and with the FBI.
It was a couple months before they would even allow us in the house.
Linda Sink was Michael Short's daughter-in-law when the murders happened and remembers vividly trying to clean the home after investigators left.
They say when a person dies, they don't bleed that much. They die instantly. They told us that Mary had died instantly, but yet when you pulled back the cover, the bed was full of blood. Jennifer's room was a mess because where they had put fingerprint stuff everywhere. I guess going in the house, it gave you the creeps too, just to know what happened in there.
As family members said goodbye to Mike and Mary, the search for Jennifer intensified.
Please release her so she can come home. Y'all miss her. And hurt beyond words.
Hours and days passed. No breaks in the case, no clues, no sign of Jennifer.